We are doing problems on normal distribution.
Now, the problem is a machine produces balls which are 10% defective. Find the probability that in a random sample of 400 balls produced by the machine, at most 30, between 30 and 50, and the next case is more than 50 balls will be defective. That is, we want to obtain these probabilities. Okay, now this is the case of the normal approximation to binomial distribution. That is, we start with binomial distribution, thus and hence, and we apply the normal approximation. That is, for large n, binomial distribution tends to normal distribution. That is, if x is the number of successes out of n, then x follows binomial with mean equal to np and variance equal to npq, so that the standard normal variable z equal to x minus np by root of npq follows n01 as n tends to infinity. Okay, let me write the result. Let x follows binomial np. Okay, then which implies expectation of x equal to np and variance of x equal to npq, so that for large n, the standard normal variable, the corresponding one, okay, z equal to x minus expectation of x by standard deviation of x, which is given by x minus np by root of npq, which is the standard deviation. As variance of x equal to npq, standard deviation of x becomes root of npq. And this is n01, which is the standard normal variable, okay, for large n. So, we approximate this distribution to normal since the sample size is large. And here, x has the number of defectives. Number of defectives out of 400. So that therefore x follows, and given that probability of a defective p, okay, equal to what is it, 10% of defective, that is 10/100, equal to 0.1. so that we know for binomial distribution q is the probability of a failure, q equal to 1 minus p equal to 1 minus 0.1 equal to 0.9, and hence we find the mean mu, expectation of x, therefore expectation of x equal to np equal to what is it, 400 into 0.1 equal to 40, and variance of x equal to npq equal to 400 into 0.1 into 0.9 equal to, it is 36, okay. So that which implies z equal to x minus np by root npq, that is x minus 40 divided by root of 36 equal to x minus 40 by 6 full loose n01. This is a very important result. The result is binomial tends to normal as n tends to infinity. Let me write here, binomial distribution tends to normal distribution as n tends to infinity. Binomial distribution tends to normal distribution as n tends to infinity. That is, we have obtained z equal to x minus 40 by 6 follows n01 as n tends to infinity. Okay. So that, let me write the result. That is, z equal to x minus 40 by 6 z equal to x minus 40 by 6 whole to cn 0 1 as n tends to infinity for large n. Okay, so that now we cover one by one. That is the first step part is, what is the probability that the number of balls is defective balls is at most 30. Okay. In a random sample of 400 balls produced by the machine, find the probability that at most 30 are defective. So that we have first case is we want to obtain probability at most 30 defectives. At most 30 means maximum 30. That is probability. We want to obtain probability x less than or equal to 30. That is, what is the problem? We want to we convert this x to z by the transformation z equal to x minus 40 by 6. So that which is equal to probability z. Okay, z is x minus 40 by 6. That is z less than or equal to 30 minus 40 by 6. Z less than or equal to 30 minus 40 by 6. So that it is equal to 30 minus 40 by 6 is minus 1.67. That is probability z less than or equal to minus 1.67. So that we represent this on the normal curve. Okay. This is the normal curve. I'm drawing a rough figure. As this is symmetric at x equal to mu, so that the corresponding value of z equal to 0, and we have to obtain this area from minus infinity up to minus 1.67. Okay, minus 1.67. We know the standard normal is symmetric at z equal to 0. That is probability z less than or equal to 0 equal to probability z greater than or equal to 0 equal to 0.5. And as this distribution is symmetric, we have the corresponding value on the right side, which is plus 1.67, and we require this area. Okay, this is equal to probability z greater than or equal to 1.67. The symmetric portion on the right side is z greater than or equal to 1.67 by symmetry. Okay, by symmetry of standard normal distribution. So that we know this area is obtained such that we from tables we obtain the value, the probability from 0 up to 1.67. So that we convert this area to that particular one. That is, this can be obtained as the area from 0 to infinity is 0.5. So we get this area equal to 0.5 minus probability 0 less than or equal to z less than or equal to 1.67. Already we have discussed in detail about the area property of normal distribution. Okay. So that this becomes 0.5 minus. Now we require the area and we take it from standard normal tables, and so that it is the value up to 1.67, that is 1.60 and 07 column, so that it is equal to 0.4525. And hence it becomes 0.0475. Let me check the value. 0.5 minus 0.4525. It is equal to 0.0475. That is, we have obtained probability z greater than or equal to 1.67 as equal to 0.0475. Okay. Now we consider the next case. we consider the next case, and the next case is what is it? Between 30 and 50. We require the probability between 30 and 50. That is, number 2 is probability of between 30 and 50 defectives. 30 and 50 defectives. Okay, so it is equal to probability 30 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 50. Okay, so it is equal to what about? It is equal to probability 30 minus 40 by 6 less than or equal to z. We convert the x, the random variable x to z. So that this is z less than or equal to 50 minus 40 by 6. And hence it is equal to probability. What is it? We have obtained it as minus 1.67 less than or equal to z less than or equal to plus 1.67. Probability minus 1.67 up to plus 1.67. So that from the standard normal curve, we obtain it as this is z equal to 0, that is x equal to mu, this is the area minus 1.67 up to plus 1.67, which is the required one. And from symmetry we know probability minus 1.67 up to 0 equal to probability 0 to 1.67, isn't it? So that we get this as, that is 2 into probability 0 less than or equal to z less than or equal to 1.67. And we have already the value as, what is the value? 1.67, it is 0.4525. That is equal to 2 into 0.4525. So it is equal to 0.905. Okay, let me check. 0.0475 into 2 equal to 0.4525. 4.4525 into 2 equal to 0.905. So the second part is 0.905, which is the probability of that the number of defectives in between 30 and 50. Let me write the answer here. That is part 2 is 0.905. Okay, now we have the other one. What is it? We want to obtain the probability that more than 50 defectives. Part 3 is probability more than 50 defectives. More than 50 defectives. So that we require the probability x greater than or equal to 50. So it is equal to probability z greater than or equal to 50 minus 40 by 6. So it is equal to probability z greater than or equal to 1.67. Already we have this probability as equal to 0.0475. We have calculated this one. Okay. As 0.5 minus probability 0 to 1.67, which is obtained as the answer is 0.0475. So that here we have the problem dealing with binomial distribution tends to normal distribution as n tends to infinity, that is for large n, and the result is what is the result? Z equal to x minus mu by sigma, that is for binomial mu equal to np, variance equal to npq. So that z equal to x minus np by root of npq follows n 0 1 as n tends to infinity, that is for large n, the normal approximation to binomial distribution. Okay, now we consider the next problem, which is, the question is given, the problem is, if x1 and x2 are two independent normal variables with means 3 and 4 and variance is 4 and 5 respectively,
find the probability 4 less than or equal to x1 plus x2 less than or equal to 13. We require the distribution of x1 plus x2, that is by the additive property we know. The result is, what is the additive property? The result is, if x1 and x2 are two independent normal variables with the parameters mu1 sigma 1 square and mu2 sigma 2 square respectively, then x1 plus x2 follows normal with mean mu1 plus mu2 and variance sigma 1 square plus sigma 2 square, okay, which is stated as the additive property of normal distribution. So let me write, what is it? X1 follows normal, mu1 equal to, what is the value, mu1 equal to 3, sigma 1 square equal to, it is 4, okay. And X2 follows normal, mu2 equal to 4 and sigma 2 square equal to 5. Okay, already given, X1 and X2 are independent. X1 and X2 are independent. Okay, so by the additive property of normal distribution, hence by the additive property of normal distribution, okay, already we have stated the additive property, and it is, the result is x1 plus x2 follows normal with mean equal to mu1 plus mu2 and variance equal to sigma 1 square plus sigma 2 square. So that here x1, that is x1 plus x2 follows normal with mean equal to, what is the mean? 3 plus 4 equal to 7, that is mu equal to 7, and sigma square equal to, what is it? Sigma 1 square plus sigma 2 square, that is 4 plus 5 equal to 9. 4 plus 5 equal to 9. Okay, and hence we and now we require the probability of this x1 plus x2, so that we want to obtain the corresponding standard normal variable, that is z equal to, okay, x1 plus x2 minus the corresponding mean 7 divided by the standard deviation, which is root 9, which is equal to 3, follows n 0 1 as n tends to, follows n 0 1, that is x minus mu by sigma follows n 0 1 for any mu and sigma, for any x following normal with mean mu and variance sigma square, the corresponding standard normal variator is z equal to x minus mu by sigma. Let me write here, if x follows n mu sigma square, okay, z equal to x minus mu by sigma follows n 0 1 as n tends to, follows n 0 1. Z equal to x minus mu by sigma follows n 0 1. This is the basic result. So that now we consider the probability, okay. The required probability is, the required probability is probability x 4 less than or equal to probability 4 less than or equal to x1 plus x2 less than or equal to 13, so that we have the corresponding x as, what is it? Z equal to x1 plus x2 minus this 3 plus 4 7 divided by root 7 by root 9 is 3. Okay, so that we get this equal to probability 4
-7/3 less than or equal to is that less than or equal to 13 minus 7 by 3. 4 minus 7 by 3 less than or equal to is that less than or equal to 13 minus 7 by 3. 4 minus 7 by 3 is minus 1. Less than or equal to is that less than or equal to 13 minus 7 by 3. What is it? 6 by 3 is 2. That is probability. Minus 1 less than or equal to is that less than or equal to 2. Now, we represent this area on the normal probability curve. And hence, we can obtain easily the value. Okay. So, that this is the standard normal curve which is symmetric as d equal to 0. And we require the area from minus 1 up to 2. So, that this is the required area, okay. This is the required probability which can be obtained as probability minus 1 to 0 plus 0 to 2. That is equal to probability minus 1 less than or equal to is it less than or equal to 0 plus probability 0 less than or equal to is it less than or equal to 2. So that, and we know this is as this normal standard normal is symmetric at z equal to 0. The corresponding area to minus 1 to 0 is equal to 0 to 1. So that we may write this as probability 0 less than or equal to z less than or equal to 1 plus probability 0 less than or equal to z less than or equal to 2 by symmetry. Okay, by symmetry. We require probability minus 1 to 0 and it is equal to probability 0 to 1 by symmetric property of normal distribution. So that we can obtain these values from standard normal tables. Okay. And hence we get probability 0 to 1 as the value corresponding to 1.0 row and 0 column. And hence it is equal to 0.34133 plus and 0 to 2 is it is equal to corresponding to the 2.0 row and 0 column and it is equal to 0.4772. 0.4772. So the answer is 0.3413 plus 0.4772. So it is equal to 0.8185. Okay, that is probability from minus 1 up to 2, it is equal to 0.8185. Okay, hence we have the apply the additive property in order to obtain the probability, the given probability. Okay, now we have covered the problems on normal distribution. Okay, thank you very much.